So students, let's now study DC current gains of a transistor. We can write that DC current gains are characteristic constants of a transistor and we can write for every transistor two current gains are defined. These are, the first one is base current amplification factor, which is denoted by a symbol beta. And it is defined as the ratio of collector current to base current. It gives us an idea about by what amount or by how many times the collector current is above the base current. And the second current gain is called ammeter current amplification factor. And it is denoted by the symbol alpha, which is given as the ratio of collector current to ammeter current. And as we already discussed that collector current is slightly less than ammeter current because base current is very small. So we can say this value of alpha is slightly less than 1. Whereas when we talk about the value of beta as base current is very small, the value of beta is quite large. So always remember alpha is slightly less than 1 unity and this beta is quite higher than unity because the value of IB is very small compared to IC. And for a transistor we already discussed that its ammeter current is the sum of base current and collector current. So using these current gains we can write that IE is IC by alpha. And IB we can write as IC by beta plus IC. So in this situation IC gets cancelled out. And this will result a relation 1 by alpha is equals to 1 by beta plus 1. Which implies a relation in the current gains of a transistor. And here we can write alpha is equals to beta by 1 plus beta. Or you can also take this 1 on the left hand side and you can represent beta in terms of alpha as alpha by 1 minus alpha. So these are the relation among the constant DC current gains of a specific transistor. This is also a quite useful relation. Always keep it in your mind.